from my research talking to people remembering their childhoods, the most vivid memories and the passionate ones are about what they did with those lollies and the cultural rituals surrounding them. So like rolling Jaffas down the aisle at the cinema was the most common memory for people in the baby boomers and older age group. You mentioned fantails before, reading the thing before the curtain goes up and you're watching the picture. That sort of cultural practice is, it's that extra stuff that surrounds the actual lolly itself, whether it's just the taste of it or ideas you've already got about it from marketing. They seem to be the strongest things, but obviously you can't separate the marketing, you can't separate the physical presence of the lolly. I actually had the privilege of going into some lolly factories to watch lollies being made. And even without the magic of film, it is magical. Just watching this sugar turn into this beautiful, colourful stuff, it's really quite an experience. So I totally understand where those writers get the impetus to write that kind of story. The generation X and Y, I think when they grow up, their memories of lollies are going to be as strong as the previous generations have been. And there is even a case for saying that maybe they'll be stronger because the lollies that they've grown up with, they've still had the licorice and the chocolate, but that's the generation that's had the sour lolly that's, you know, since probably the 1990s, that's been the sort of that extreme mouth experience is what these kids have been after. So if they're having that more extreme experience, maybe the memories are going to be that much more vivid. So the Violet Crumble Bar is one of the Australian iconic confections, and Hoadley made that, and working out that you put the chocolate on was a way of stopping it from sticking together. It kept it dry, and then he had heaps of trouble getting a wrapper that would give it a good shelf life. So that foil wrapper, he had that specially produced in France, that purple foil. The history of Australian confectionery is full of all this wonderful trivia, but it's actually really important when you think about it. We wouldn't have Violet Crumbles if Mr. Hoadley hadn't worked out a way to stop it sticking to itself.